Actually, it is. No matter what it is, the requirement, what the job is, changes how you approach it. Meaning, like, I work for Harvey Cullins, and there is no evolution to the character of Richie Rich, Casper for your ghost or anything. The real process was absolutely learning how to draw like somebody else. And it was actually far harder to draw Casper for your ghost than it is to draw Superman. Superman has a body, a big male body, and it's your idea of heroic, and whether you have more muscle or less muscle, they don't care. They just care that you have your own personal style to some degree about what Superman is. But Casper is a lima bean going this way, and a certain type of lima bean, a very healthy lima bean going this way. And that same healthy lima bean going in the opposite direction, and the 2 feet between the words. You gotta place the eyes in the right place. If you don't do that, then you're not drawing Mitch, you know, little hot stuff. He's that's the very center of drawing all those characters. And so that became the homework. It actually took me 3 months to learn how to draw that way. Same thing for, let's say, Disney or something. The characters don't have their big evolution in character. They have one that they basically repose, they're basically the same. All princesses, you know, have all this stuff and then they lose some of it and they go where they're going. Princes are strong and whatnot, and until they encounter the female, puts a question of what's fair and what is strong. That's it. Really, pretty much nothing left. Whereas, working for Marvel as an evolution, working with DC, I was actually the first person to draw Muscles from Wonder Woman. And they called me into an office and said, yeah, she's a little muscular. I said, well, you know, it's really more than the faces than that. You know, she's, you know, you guys have been writing since this Charles Moulton guy, and let's face it, he's just a little freaky. And all he wanted really was just to draw this woman in the box. But if she was an Amazon, she hate men. And he goes, oh, yeah, I said, no, come on. You know, if you took a Klansman and he had children, and it just went on for maybe 500 generations of KKK people, and then you took that one kid and placed him in Harlem. Is he going to suddenly start liking the people around him? Or does he have to go through an evolution of learning why he's supposed to be there? And what is he there for? Not just something he likes. And they went, yeah, they agreed. And then the process started from there. So whether I drew or not, I had a, what's the word for it? I had influence, and I changed something without even me being there. I drew for a year, but all the real change came together. I said, she's got to be angry. They couldn't personally make her angry. So Jeff Wolf, the thing I was working with, created Armageddon, so whatever I did. And she was orange-haired and whatnot, and they dressed her the same like Wonder Woman, you know, half-dressed. But she hated men and she killed them all the time. And Wonder Woman had someone to fight with and figure out why they are the way they were. That was pretty good. That was the first good take. And the first time she made money. Wonder Woman actually didn't know what to do because she never made a dime except in during World War II. After that, she never made a dime. They actually kept her because she was a great woman. Working with Clive Barker was a great experience. You know, it's all about this human condition of wanting something that's not good. Wanting something that's going to change things around you. And, you know, that idea of selling your soul, but it's really you selling yourself about something you've always wanted. That's your nature. And it was a great piece of it. He had a conversation with me about a slice, a cake, being alive and wanting to be cake. And the only objective of the cheesecake is to be eaten. That's it. But when you sliced it, each slice became a person. And each slice lived the life of being eaten. And it was the pleasure of being eaten that was completely the opposite of this new movie. What's it called?
Sausage Party.
It was actually the very opposite. It was a piece of cake, desiring to be cake, wanting to be eaten, and be cake too. You know? And see, and that's the very nature. And I think that really all of you, but this is being called anime comic, has gotten the evolution of what comic books are about from anime. Because anime talks about everything in its entirety. So what they're talking about, a little life or a big life, it's all life. And everybody's life is an adventure within itself. And that the highs and lows of it is experienced on that personal level, and that you traumatize that personal level to the best of your ability. And so whether it's something subtle or something very strong, it comes across better with those personal pictures, those personal images. And I think that's the thing that's changing comic books as it is. It isn't really about the spandex, because Spider-Man had the spandex, but really what we're more interested in is whether Peter Parker's going to get Mary Jane or not. You know, that becomes the bigger picture. And that was what Marvel granted, but anime has granted the little person who goes to work salary now. The return of Pinocchio as Astro, or you know, Vampire Hunter D, the crossbreed problem.